Hi guys, hope you all are doing good. Today's topic is pricing. We are going to look at pricing models. This is Chandan, Techno Digital Marketing Expert. Hope you will like this video. Please leave your comments and feedback.
So the first pricing model is competitive pricing. What is competitive pricing? Let's take example. So we have multiple competitors in the market. What you can do is immediately, you can set the price same as your competitor, or you can set the price as average of 2-3 competitors, or you can set your price lower than or lesser than your competitor. Let's take example here that Manish is selling one product at 100 rupees. Okay. So any other competitor of Manish comes into the market and he tries to sell it, he will try to sell it at 105 rupees. Another competitor comes in, he will try to sell it at 95 rupees. Another competitor comes in, he tries to sell it at 80 rupees. Another competitor comes in, he will try to sell it at 120 rupees. So the competitive pricing depends on who are available in the market and depending on your product. But you have to remember here that the product price have to be, you have to have a profitable margin on top of your all the cost. So it should not happen that your product cost is, the price is lesser than the all the costs. Okay, so to get the advantage of all the best profit margin, you can set the price according to the competitive pricing method. Most important part you have to remember here is it is reactive method. It is not for leaders. So if there is a competitor who comes in the market and he changes the price, then you guys will also change the price. And once the price is changed, the customer also reacts according to the price. He is also reactive to all the pricing that is done in the market. Okay, so the leaders generally do not take these reactive actions. They drive the market, they set the price, and everybody follows it. So you have to remember this. So generally, not always competitive pricing is suggested, but most important part you have to remember here is you have to know your competitor's price. Okay, so as we had said in the beginning, the first pricing method is method, I said that cost plus profit is equal to price. But let's say your cost is 80 rupees, your profit is 15 rupees or 20 rupees, so your price is 100 rupees. But what if the competitor are selling it at 250 rupees, or all the competitors are selling between the range of 180 rupees to 225 rupees? Why should you sell your products in the range of 100 rupees? You can earn more profit margin, right? Because customer is ready to pay and they are already paying to another your competitors. So you cannot set your price to 110 or 115. We suggest that you set the price according to the competitor. So this is the first method. Okay, the second model is the break-even strategy. So cost base for paying the bills. If you can pay your bills, all your costs are paid, okay, and you can earn some profit. Actually, there is no profit. There is a, it is the point where there is no profit and there is no loss. Okay, so this is, are you doing business for this purpose? No, right? So it may be good in the beginning. It is not for a long-term strategy. Okay. Or when you are entering a new marketplace, it is good. Okay. Or when you want to test a particular market, you can use these kind of strategies. You can use this strategy to acquire a large volume of customers. So what we saw, the penetration strategy. So sometimes in the beginning, you use this break-even strategy or a cost-based strategy. It can be used as your penetration strategy, which we have seen, to acquire large volume of customers. But remember that this is not good for a very long term business. Your business will not run you will go into losses, you know, in the long run. Okay, so this is the second pricing strategy. Third pricing model, okay, it is price to time model. What is price to time means? Now, price to time means, you know, you charge per hour, or charge per day, or charge per month. So mainly it is used by professionals, lawyers, freelancers, consultants. Okay. Now what we are seeing is, you know, there is a move towards, it is called the gig economy, or it is moving from job economy to a skill economy. Okay. So in this job economy or a skill economy, charge per hour, charge per day, charge per month, this is, you know, seen going up. Okay. But there is a flip side to it. Companies, the organizations may not prefer it because they prefer to work as for results. So you say that, you know, I will work for 10 hours and my fees is this. But how much work will you complete in that particular 10 hours? Is that also, you know, decided? If it is result oriented and in 10 hours you are going to complete this amount of work, then you will get, you know, what you have been the price for time. Okay, but what if you are not delivering that result? So this will not work in that respect also. So there is a conflict of interest. Okay, here. So another pricing model is price to cost. Now this is also a very simple method. It is also widely used. So all these four above, you know, are widely used methods in India. So percentage of all cost, this is also used in, you know, architectural companies, building companies, or even the advertising companies. Okay, so there is a cost involved in developing something. Okay, so the agency will charge some percentage on all the costs incurred. So suppose you know, architect will come and he will say that, you know, I will charge you whatever the cost of material required for the building this particular apartment and renovating this particular apartment. So the cost of renovating this apartment is, let's say, 1 crore. I will charge you 15% of all the costs involved. So he will charge you 15 lakh rupees. Okay, so this is the cost that you can charge. So this is called the price to cost. Again, in this pricing method also, this pricing model. So actually I have differentiated between the pricing method, pricing strategy, and the pricing models. Okay, so this is I'm calling it pricing models. Okay, so here also, if the cost increases of a particular, you know, interior design work, the price of the contractor also increases. So architect is going to charge more. Again, customer will not be happy here. Okay, he will say that, you know, why is my cost increasing? You know, I will pay you fixed cost only. So this is the problem again in this price per cost. But there are many companies using this pricing method. So there is also a conflict of interest for an organization here. Okay. So what customer always say that, you know, price should be result focused as well as time focused. So what customer says that, you know, I want this particular amount of work to be completed in so much time, and I want this results out of, you know, activities that has been performed. He will not say that, you know, I will you do as much as time and, you know, put as much as cost to it, and then, you know, you will charge me percentage cost to it. You know, he wants to reduce the cost of development of anything, you know, the customer. So this price to cost model is also a very famous model, and it is being widely used, okay, in the market. Next is price to package. This is a very very interesting model. So what you do is, you know, you bundle multiple products and services to give a good deal to the customer. Okay, so this is called the packaging. Family pack, combo pack is there, na, in MACD also. So that is called, you know, the, and it is, you know, very the price is in such a way that, you know, a lot of people prefer to buy such combo packs. Then, you know, it is very inexpensive for them to buy. At the same time, you know, three burgers, you know, multiple fries and, you know, multiple cokes that you get, you know, you get a large quantity of product, and company also sells, you know, many products in one particular order. Okay, so bundling multiple products and services to give a good deal to the customer, which he generally cannot refuse. Okay, so create an offer, you know, there is an offer to the customer, and this offer is irresistible. He cannot say no to it, because, you know, he is getting 3-4 things at a very low cost. Then you have price to positioning. Now, what is price to positioning? So if you are a good brand, you can charge a lot more, and customers are then willing to pay. Okay, so the perception of a product is extremely good. People are ready to pay the premium. If you understand another most important part, if you understand the supply and demand, you can charge more. Okay, so for example, there are some products which are, you know, the pricing is also flexible, you know. So if there is a more demand, you can increase the price. If you are a lesser demand, you know, there is, you know, you can decrease them. So it's called the flexible pricing. But if you can understand this demand, okay, of a customer, you can charge more, okay, for that particular demand. So this is how, you know, the demand increase in demand, and if the supply is less, the price is higher. Okay, and if the demand is less and supply is more, the price will be lower automatically. Okay, now a very important part: can you create the demand? So there are, you know, possible ways that, you know, with advertising, marketing, communication, you can create the demand in the market, okay, for your products and services. Most important is pricing models is price to value. If you sell results, you know, people are ready to pay the premium. Okay, so this is in the service industry, especially if you see, if you tell them that, you know, you give value to them, not just the product, you know, you have to understand, you know, what are the results that they are expecting. If you sell, able to sell that, they are ready to pay very high premium. They are not, they will not only pay you the cost plus profit or the competitors, you know, price, but they will pay you more. Example, I'll tell you, I can give you a percentage growth from the baseline. Let's say, you know, their baseline is $1 million, let's say, example, and you are saying that, you know, you will make it 5 million over the period of 3 years, and you give them, you know, different ways of increasing their business. Okay, so then, and you can say that, you know, whatever the additional business that you are generating, I will charge you so much of a, you know, my service charges or service fees. So these fees are going to be much higher than, you know, if you ask for, you know, give me, you know, consultation charges, or give me website charges, or give me this charges or that charges. Okay, so you can charge extremely higher on the growth of customer's business. So this is called the pricing, price to value. As a marketeer and from the Indian consumer point of view, I always say that, you know, the price of your product should not be low, you know, it should be beneficial to your customer so that he gets the maximum value. The Indian companies try to keep their product to a very low price. Okay, so generally they try to keep their price to cost plus profit, you know, very less margins they work on. So because of which, you know, they cannot grow very fast. Okay, so what, as a marketeer, what you have to see is, you know, how do you get maximum price from your customer so that your profitability margin increases. So whenever I would suggest, you know, whenever you are trying to set the price of a product, first find all the costs involved, okay, including, you know, all your manufacturing costs, all the overheads, then all the distribution costs, then all your marketing promotion cost, and then add up all this. Top of that, you put your profit margin, good profit margin you put in, okay, let's say 20%, 30%, and then see, you know, what is the price that you have came out with. Okay, now this price you have to check with your competitor's pricing. So if this price is even less than, you know, competitor's price, increase your profit margin and then use some of the pricing strategies that we have discussed, whether you are going to be the economic model or whether you are going to be penetration model or whether you are going to be, you know, premium model or whether you are going to be skimming model. Okay, suppose then decide this, you know, and then set the pricing models in the end. Okay, so this is the way you can set the price for your product.